The season 2, episode 2 of the Halo Council, DMAQ, Gandhi, and Elamite in the building. We got a lot of shit to talk about. Action packed show. So, motherfuckers, let's start talking. Elamite, Gandhi, we had a week between the show, not even, but a lot of shit went down. A lot of team changes. We talked to Ninja last week. All of a sudden, we were talking about Mikwin, him being on a new team, but guess what? Kyle's brother here pulled a shady-ass move and left him. So, what happened in the past couple days, guys?
Kyle, before this gets in, and I just want to set this rule here, I love Ace. DMAQ loves Ace. We know he's your brother, and you have to defend him. If it was my brother, I would defend him to the death. So it's okay that whatever answer you give us is sugar-coated and kind of bullshit, but please walk us through it. I want
to
hear...
I actually have not talked to him about what has happened.
Of course.
Yeah.
No, but it's so cliche. People are comparing it to certain other team changes and whatnot. I don't think it's even close to being on that level. Like, we don't know. When a team comes together at the last second, you know, and then, like, 2 seconds later they switch teams, I don't consider it necessarily as bad as, like, a ticket's booked, this going on, regular scheduled event, team change.
Ticket was booked, right?
Were they booked?
All of them, their tickets.
I would assume.
All their tickets had to have been booked. Plus, the team passes were sold out now?
Is your ticket booked? Your ticket's booked.
Mine, I'm good.
Yeah.
Is yours booked? Because MLG books flights very late.
Yeah,
they do book flights at the last minute. I think this was basically, they just entered the zone where you couldn't make any team games. Maybe like 4 or 5 days prior, that time began. And we were talking about it. Maybe that ninja move should have been the last team change,
but it didn't create a tornado. You know, there was no team change tornado.
Yeah, it just fucked over two people who were paying out of their pocket to go to an exhibition where only top three gets paid out.
Scotty. Bam! Thank you. Boom.
I did it just for you, man.
Okay. All right.
I'm a sucker for brown people, man. You know.
Have either one of you guys talked to them though?
No, not a. I can talk to Mikwin. I could send him a text or a tweet. I can do either of those.
Everything we know so far is based on Twitter, though.
Yes, but we do know that your brother left Mikwin and Twilight. Which is it a better team change for going to Dursky?
And that's what I'm saying.
Probably, it's probably a better team change.
Yes.
So it makes sense, but it comes down to. Everyone being upset because Mikwin does have a fan base, and you know I'm a fan of Mikwin. He's actually a pretty cool dude.
Great
but,
player.
Yeah, average player. just kidding.
I thought he was the best player on Straight Ribbon at the end of the season last year.
That's not saying a whole lot, though. That is not saying a whole lot. But
I mean, he was better than Ninja. He was better than Squared. I thought for a little bit. Well, Squared was getting good at the end, though. I'm not gonna lie. But
maybe.
Here's my thoughts on this. I think, although this was something that was pretty last minute, again, this is an exhibition. You know what I'm saying?
I'm seriously going to gouge your eyes out, man.
And you can't let a team really settle just after 24 to 48 hours. You know, that doesn't really mean that team is really formed. It takes about a week or two to really staple that squad as a team.
Right. It's way more. It's way bigger too when you have to send team builder emails and Anakin, and there's all kind of deadline restrictions and teams break those and whatnot. I can't say that this wasn't a shady move because two people did get screwed over, and I think most people in the league, or majority of the people in the league, have been screwed over and know exactly how it feels and exactly what goes into it. But until we know the exact reason, it is hard to speculate on exactly why that team change happened.
All right, well, let's go ahead and spin it to this. When should there be a deadline or a penalty, we can go with either, before an event comes that you can't have a team change, period? When can that be? I mean, now since there's technically no pro teams, we've pretty much gotten rid of pro seeds, even though it's an exhibition. We have no proceeds, so what are they going to do? Cap everyone so 2 weeks before you can't switch your team?
Well, actually, tell a victim to this too, though. There has been people who just don't show up to the event.
Yeah.
Or impersonate other people and show up to the event. I think you are the classic case of that. And then thinking back later, Zios and whoever else bailed out and, you know, Sheriff and had to find a new fourth. Chicago, I think.
I don't know. I just remember my incident. Ohio Valley shootout.
Your incident's a good story.
No, it's a it's a terrible story.
Well, Scott, let's run it down, your incident, in quick bullet points.
What happened to me? Triple X posed as Gringo for like 3 weeks, covert op like a son of a bitch, showed up to Ohio Valley, keep in mind I'm like 12, have no fourth, fucking just GG. I still beat him. We still took second. I lost to fucking Xena, though, in MOD, M-O-D.
Okay.
Awful.
So this is one player impersonating another one to sabotage a team. That's
exactly
what happened.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they laugh it up, man. I'll come through it. I'll choke you out.
Shady Halo Play have erupted from the grassroots. We've been shady right from the get. Jersey being shady back in the day, it happens.
Monopoly
it happens
drops.
To the best of us. I've not invited people to LANs because I was like, you know, I don't want him to jump on this team because I'm not that good. So if he comes, I'm gonna get my ass kicked and off the. You know what I'm saying? So. It happens.
Okay, but...
That's manipulation.
Yeah, that's just you being a scumbag. That's completely different. But seriously, though, I would personally say that 3.5 weeks out, they have to bring back proceeds in some way, shape, or form. And it should be kind of like a power ranking. It shouldn't just be like MLG events so we can actually have like something decent. It should be like taking AGL into consideration in other tournaments like EGL if it starts getting bigger and just throw together this big fucking algorithm so you can get... separate teams, or at least some kind of a seed in FFA. Something to have an advantage. You should be rewarded for being good at the game. Everyone shouldn't be on the same playing field, because that's bullshit. You don't get rewarded then for being the best, and I personally think if you're the best, you should get rewarded for it. Look at Karma in the 2006 FFA. He shit on everyone, and he always had host, and it was completely unfair, but you had to beat him. And he still had host in 2007, and he lost. Eventually, it'll catch up to you. Just because someone has an advantage doesn't mean they're always going to be better than you. And host now is almost a joke. I mean, in Halo 3 and Halo Reach was awful. It was almost like a hindrance to have host.
Yeah, that whole thing has changed. I'm about to play Halo 1 with my cousins in a pair. I'm going to have to let them have host all night. And if the games are going to be close because it's such a big advantage. You know, host back in the day was crazy.
Yeah,
and Halo 2.
Like two different games.
Uh-huh.
All right, so moving on. I reached out to basically a bunch of pros through text messaging, and I was like, dude, if you have anything to say, any public comments, let me know what they are. And so I'll do it at the beginning of the show, and if a couple more pros hit me up, I'll do it at the end of the show too, right?
He just wants pros' numbers so he can hang out with them.
It's
such a sad ploy.
I'm not
such
going
a
to
sad
Dallas.
Ploy.
Remember this.
You're not? At all?
I'm not going to go to Dallas. I'm not going to be.
Why?
It'll be my first missed MLG in like 4.5 years.
But why?
To be honest, they weren't paying me to do much of nothing for the past year. So I give it up to the MLG. I wasn't doing much at the events. I was just hanging out. And so it's cool. You know.
Keep all the pros level-headed.
I do. I'm a calming presence. I will agree to that.
Exactly.
I do.
You're a calming force.
Strong Side hit me up. He's another one that's not going to be there. This is the first MLG tournament I'm going to miss in my 7 years of gaming. I wish I could be there. I'm not going to make it to the tournament because Walsh and I are going on tour through Asia to promote Halo 4.
Do they have a translator?
To play Halo 4 in Australia, and I really enjoyed the changes made to the game. 343 brought a new and improved feel to Halo. I think they went to the right direction with this game, picking up pieces from throughout the Halo series and adding some new great features. I can't wait to see some great matches in Dallas. Shout-outs. Oh, he does have shout-outs. Strong Side is a connected dude, so I'm going to do this for him. Tough Drink Nos. Okay, you got it. And buy a Strong Side shirt from bonafideboarding.com. All right.
And can we roll it at that? Because I'm bored.
That's the longest one. I started with the longest one.
Yeah, no, but okay. So can I get a reaction here and ask, like, some questions?
Oh,
one, do they have a translator? because if they're going to go and promote Halo 4 in Asia, I don't think any of them studied Mandarin in high school.
Yeah, I wouldn't say they're bringing the two most cultured dudes. They're bringing two guys from the Midwest and up top and Washington strong side. Straight dudes who are going to want McDonald's for their meal. So, kind of awesome experience for both of them.
Yeah, second thing, I'm super jealous. I'm super jealous. I've never left this continent. So I can only imagine the fun they're going to have. But why Asia? Why not, like, Europe, where at least the gaming scene's kind of present, you know? Like, what is it about Asia? Does anyone know these? Am I just asking open-ended questions here? Or do you have answers for me?
No, I'm not even playing with this. One time, I was chilling at home. My boy, my, like, closest friend, he was in Pakistan. And he texted me. He's like, yo, why the fuck is MLG on my TV right now? We only get 13 channels. And on one of them is Major League Gaming. And the reason is because there's so much free TV time, and really MLG just invested all this money. So why not go to Asia now? It makes sense. MLG's already investing time into there. Now Halo 4 investing time into there. And hopefully one day we could get some events.
Right. I mean, Asia is a huge, huge base of people there. I mean, billions of people over there in Asia. So if there is any kind of pickup on the game, it's going to be more successful than it would be in Europe, I would say. Yeah. Like, if Halo 4 picks up at all, it could blow up, even if it's just a small percentage of the people they're playing. And it's already proven to be that they're into video games. They're more into video games than anywhere else in the world. I think it's a great decision. The tour is going to be insane. Like, that opportunity is once in a lifetime. And on top of that, the experiences and whatever else they're doing over there, and whoever's hosting it, I don't know much about it, but like that is an opportunity and a half.
Yeah, that's sick.
Fucking jealous.
I'm so jealous. Yeah, you don't even see me, and you know I'm jealous. You can just see you can feel the jealousy.
Sure, I can feel it from Virginia.
Yeah, what's up,
Dursky? Hit me up. Dynasty will bring their A game. That is all. Fucking typical Dursky. It should say I will be there with a sleeveless shirt on. That is all. That's probably what's going to happen. Bravo. All I got to say is Columbus was big. Let's make Dallas 10 times bigger. We've been given a huge opportunity. Let's hit up all the blogs, promote the event. Can't be. Oh, it's going to be huge. Yeah, 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 yeah. Blah. And that's Bravo.
I'm so ready for this segment to be done, son.
Smackdown. If Toxic Euphoria's team and Florida Jackalopes don't get top four after getting the game a month before everyone else, they should publicly say how much better pros are adapting to games.
That was a good one. I like that.
That was the best one. You should have opened with that and kept it with that.
I saved the best one for last.
I mean, I agree tenfold with what he has to say, but let's go ahead and get into the heated debate here. This is the one, all right? This is it.
You're not ready.
Before we go into that, then, I got a email from or a text from Ace, so we can get a little.
Oh, wow, fantastic! Down here.
Thought I might go look into that.
Oh, thank God you got a text from your brother.
He said timing's unfortunate, but he doesn't believe it was shady. He said they made the team. They got hit up by Destin. They said overall they weren't confident with only top four getting paid out. They weren't confident that they would get paid to it. You know, make money or not, if you're not going for top four, then, you know, you're kind of shit out of luck.
Yeah.
He said they only played one time, and 4 hours later after they started talking, they made the change. Hmm. I would put it on the upper level of shady, like the, you know, not as shady, but you could still call it shady. It's a borderliner.
Okay. I will agree with that, I guess.
The top four thing throws it off a lot.
It does. You know, it does.
Really, really does. You know,
the fact that it's an exhibition, correct?
Exhibition throws it off, too.
I'm so tired of this word.
Are there points involved?
That's a great question. We should probably do research next time before. We ask too many fucking questions. That's our problem here. If anyone knows in the chat, I don't have this up, but one of these guys, let us know if you get points from this. Because if you get points from this, then DMAQ, you can take your exhibition and shove it square up your ass. But let's move on, all right? I got multiple tweets from this saying we should talk about this on the show. Sundance tweeted something along the lines of, which would you prefer on the circuit, Halo 4 or Call of Duty Black Ops 2? Clearly we know what we're going to say. All of us here. All of us. We know what to expect. But let's say why. I'm going to kick it off with DMAQ first, because D, I just can't wait to hear what you got to say. But why do you think it should be Halo, or if it should be Halo, over COD?
First of all, I don't like the question.
You don't?
It's over here doing exactly what we've been fighting not to do, is dividing these communities. Okay, so I don't really care for that at all. But secondly, there's really not a comparison. If I'm going to keep it real, if I'm going to really be honest, a real first-person shooter, there's really only one clear console first-person shooter, and that's Halo. And really, it's only there because Halo 1 was such a true shooter. Okay, that's the only reason Halo is still considered a primetime shooter. It still has some elements of that. And Call of Duty never really had that, man. It never really established itself to be competitive right from the start. And that's why I feel that it's unfair to think that they're going to be there now. And so that's what I think. And personally, I don't like the question at all. Because, again, if that's what you're into, Call of Duty, sure. But you know what? I've been doing this shit for like 10, 12 years now, man. And I've been around and I like Halo way better than Call of Duty. I've played Call of Duty for months on end. It's a lot of fun. But if I'm going to a tournament, a competitive tournament that I play all fucking year for, it's going to be a Halo tournament if it's on the console and it's a first-person shooter. That's it.
Kyle?
I thought he said it pretty well. The whole part of bringing up not to divide the communities is huge, because it is at that level where... And it's bad for esports in general when, you know, Call of Duty kids are making fun of Halo kids and Gears of War and StarCraft and League of Legends, even PC to console. If everyone was united, it would be so much better.
Yeah, but fuck that. Their game's better, or our game's better.
Exactly. I mean, I don't know how many times I have to listen to
In Control tweet some bullshit or
whatever it is.
That corner. And you know what? We are going to fight for our game, so... My bad. Continue, Kyle.
Yeah, but regardless of what it is, Halo, it started off. It's a great series. Call of Duty, I mean, they crank... What is the schedule when those games come out? How often do they come out?
It's like every year. About every year.
I mean, that's pushing it. I feel like... The new one looks great, though, by the way. Let me
they got off. Just
the
about everything.
Looks fucking sick. But, you know, it's getting a little repetitive. I feel like so many coming in and out every year. When Halo, you know, I can't say that they do much better at it, but overall... I mean, it's been the biggest competitive game. It might not have had the biggest tournament, like the Call of Duty million-dollar tournaments and whatnot, but it also has Microsoft instead of, you know, like Activision and whoever else is involved in Call of Duty, where, you know, you've got Microsoft pushing out like, oh, you guys can't make money off of our game, and then you got Activision who's pumping money into the game.
Yeah. I look at it like this. Two things. Just to agree with D again, console gaming, we're kind of frowned upon in the scene of professional gaming. I don't say esports. I think the word's retarded. I don't like it. You don't see, you know, pool be called billiard sports. It's not B sports. It's called professional pool. I stand by that. Don't care if you guys agree with me. Just throwing that out there. But we, if you want to look at it realistically, if anything, it should be Halo 4 and Call of Duty splitting the main stage for time, which I'm assuming is what they're doing with League of Legends and Halo 4 at Dallas. I'm assuming that's how it's working since they have 8 teams. They used to do that with Call of Duty back in the day with League of Legends. So you have COD and Halo flip-flopping games on the main stage, and you still have one huge station. I mean, for attendance-wise, both team games are probably going to sell out realistically, because that's just how console gaming goes. Most of the viewers, or the majority of the viewers, actually go to compete as well. So you're going to have what? An extra 1,600 kids running around instead of just a simple 800?
Well, which is what? The part is they can't just process. They can't run that extra tournament or an extra game.
Well,
you think like there's just enough time and enough stations?
Well, how about a quick solution? And this is what I've been preaching, you know, for the last year now, and this is what I think is going to be a good idea, is next year, including Gears of War in that same conversation,
yep,
instead of having a 250-man team tournament, or a 250-team tournament, have online qualifiers. Invite the best 80 teams out, all right? Whoever decides to come out, that's cool. Among those bottom of the 80 teams, you know, some of them are not going to show up. That's fine. all right? But invite 80 teams out from each community. We have Gears of War here, we have Call of Duty, and we have Halo 4. And then let's have a console first-person shooter side. And why wouldn't that be cool? That would unite everybody. That would be make everybody happy. The top gamers get to come out and represent their game. You know, the prize money would be cool. And you know what? The stream numbers would fly out the fucking roof. And so really, on all aspects, we're looking at problem solved. But instead, we're here asking ourselves a question because really, guys, it comes down to money. Sponsorships run everything. And if it's going to be Call of Duty, it's bought by Sony. And if it's going to be Halo 4, it's going to be paid by Microsoft. Typical sponsorship bullshit. And you know what? I'm not falling into that trap. I don't work there anymore. So I don't really give a fuck.
But, you know, and then to make my second point to the entire argument, if anyone technically needs MLG, it's Halo. We have shit. We can't self-sustain. What do we have, AGL that's going to have a couple events here and there? Most of the pros will drop off by then if MLG doesn't pick up the game. There's not enough money involved, and I don't blame them to do it. You know, a lot of these players have been dedicating their lives to this game. Most of them have done barely any school, myself included. I'll have an associate at 23 come spring, you know? That's just because I put this much time into the scene just to basically, you know, get kind of shit on by Bungie with Reach. But nonetheless, we don't have a spectator mode. We can't self-sustain. The developer really doesn't give two fucks about the competitive scene, from at least from what we've seen thus far. I'm not saying that's going to change or if it will change, but if anything, Halo needs it because you got... Look at the figures in Call of Duty alone. You got Fwiz, you got Optic, you have Hasher, you have Envious, you have Leverage, you have all of these humongous industries, and Machinima backs them all, and Machinima is now starting to get into Halo as well as they're starting to voyage out, but those are huge companies, man. They're huge teams. These players are on salaries, not to mention Eon as well, which is a part of Envious, but it's absurd. They don't need it, if anything. They'll be perfectly fine whether MLG picks it up or not. In fact, most of them are probably like, eh, well, I don't really care if MLG picks it up because we're going to be fine. Whereas we're like, well, if MLG doesn't pick it up, we're fucked. See you guys on Twitter.
It's true. And I never really thought that there would be a possibility that MLG didn't pick it up.
Yeah.
Well, what about EGL? Do you guys know anything about the tournament over in England?
I knew... Base knowledge, man.
Like, what about team-wise? Like, number of attendance or viewership or anything like that? I don't know if they ever released.
I know the EGL for Call of Duty hit. I don't want to do it. I got into it with Nade Shot. I want to say it was like... I want to say it was like 10K. 10K for a quote-unquote dead game or whatever. Which is good for that. And then for Halo, I want to say it was probably 2K, 3K. But, I mean... So, I mean, right there, it's nothing special, but, I mean, it's still pretty decent for console gaming. But that's the scary, that's another thing that's scary. I mean, oh, wow, D, you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Oh, Kyle dropped out. Oh well. Shit. But that's another thing that's scary is that, you know, if you're talking, sponsor obligations are imperative. And, you know that, I know that. How long do you actually think we'll get on the circuit? You know what I mean? I mean, you're going to have League of Legends, you're going to have Dota out of beta. You're going to have Dota 2 coming out of beta. You're going to want these games on the circuit. How long do you think MLG would keep, you know, Halo around or Call of Duty? Realistically. Yeah, you just got to turn on your camera, sweetheart.
What was that?
I mean, yo, Scotty, I agree with you 100%, you know. And here's the thing, is Call of Duty by itself is not going to be able to survive, all right? I really don't think so. I mean, it is and it isn't. There's going to be a lot of tournaments for it, but as far as a spectator thing, it's not going to be able to survive and bring people in, okay? Just like League of Legends isn't the game that's going to bring people in esports, StarCraft is. Okay, StarCraft is that game on the PC that will bring people into esports rather than League. League is more of a game that you have to play it, right? Call of Duty is a game that you really have to play. And Halo is a game that everybody could just watch. And it's so competitive, and it's a game that really has been competitive right from the beginning. And that's why, Scotty, it makes me mad when you say, you know, they haven't been paying attention to the competitiveness. They haven't been paying attention to the spectator mode. Motherfucker, they've been a competitive title since the beginning. And that's what they've geared themselves to every single title. And
you want
to
go down this road?
I don't expect
them. You want to go down this road?
I don't expect them to go away from this. That's what I'm saying.
I think they move away from it, but coming back to Halo 4, they put in an extra thought to make it competitive. You know what? I don't think that competitiveness was their main target when they've been going on and continuing the genre, but I feel like they have been paying extra attention now. They have been listening to the community and making changes appropriately to keep make everyone happy.
Absolutely, they have.
Oh, by the way, I got a tweet from, I think it was like Magic Speed Racer, something Speed Racer. I don't know. I looked at a glance, but 67% voted for Call of Duty.
Ooh.
By the way. But then again, you know, but if you want to go with the Twitter poll, you want to talk about unfair. Yeah, you got X-Jaws, who's a cool-ass dude. I love X-Jaws. He's a good friend. Yeah, like 168,000 following. T. Martin's got like 120. I think the highest Halo person's what? Walshy with like 20?
Yeah, 20.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
put that in. I mean, I don't know why Halo's such a better game, but it's so hard to compete with Call of Duty. It's definitely a brain buster for me.
I don't get it. I haven't figured it out, man.
Is Call of Duty is the most popular game in the world on consoles. You know, it's number one and number two. Fucking Modern Warfare 3 is number one. And fucking Black Ops is number two. It's ridiculous.
Well, then again, online play is great for Halo, except for Halo Reach because it fucking sucked so bad. It was the most annoying thing to play.
People have gone away from the game. They've gone away from the franchise. They've moved on to other shit. And at the same time, you have 20 million people playing Call of Duty right now. But still, Halo puts up one-third of the votes. Still. Nobody's played the shit. Have you played Halo Reach? When's the last time you played?
Are you talking to me or Kyle?
Yeah, I'm talking to you, Scotty. When's the last time you played that shit? Because I haven't played.
Realistically?
Realistically?
Fuck. Hold on. October 2011.
Dude, and that's what I'm saying. It's still a game that nobody even plays. Still, we get one-third the votes.
Like, you can't even enjoy it random matchmaking. It's not even enjoyable. Like, given every game for all the competitive players out there, if you've ever been on a team, you know, playing against another team is a hell of a lot of fun. Like, that's the best when, you got big competition, you know, really competitive thing going on. Yeah. But what's not is when you go into matchmaking and you've got, you know, three idiots on your team playing four good kids and you're going to spawn rate the whole time. Or if you go in, you get three good kids on your team and you have four idiots on the other team and you're spawn raping them the entire time. That's not even, it's not even fun for me. It's just a waste of time.
Yeah.
I don't really hear about COD lands like we used to have camps, you know, and they didn't really exist like we used to have camps. And I think Call of Duty is a tournament game, definitely, but it's a tournament game online. And that's where it's been successful for MLG. That's where it should stay. And you know what? If Halo has to do some stuff online so Call of Duty could come make a splash live, that's cool too. We could share the stage. I'm not saying we can't. But if you're making me, pushing me against the wall and telling me what should I choose and what's better, I'm going to keep it real and tell you that Call of Duty isn't even a real fucking game, okay? Only girls play Call of Duty. Like that's what I'm going to say. But, you know, I mean, every chick that plays video games, the first game that they play is Call of Duty, okay? That's just a fact. No chick really says Halo.
It's true. It is easier to play, I think.
All right.
You know what I think it is? I think it comes down to just the skill it takes for, like, in Halo to hit him multiple times in the body, whereas, you know, Call of Duty is like once, you know? You just got to connect with a couple bullets. But Halo, it's like you got to keep that fucking reticle on him at all times. And even if you get the first, like, three shots, which 90% of the time in Call of Duty, if their back's turned to you and you shoot them once, you get the kill, you know? Very rarely do you see people get turned on. But in Halo, you get turned on the regular, especially when you choke, and you get punished for that. Mm-hmm. And I think that just adds to it. It's the whole competitive scene of it.
And you really need to look at how many people play Call of Duty that just plain suck at video games. Because everyone I know that's good at video games or not good at video games or has been to MLGs or doesn't go to MLGs drops like 70 and 5 or, you know, I just went 120 and 3. It's like, how the hell do you even possibly do that unless everyone else in the game is horrible or you've got like, you know, two people on each team, each one's plus 100 and then, you know, everyone else is negative 65 or something. Just like, really, how bad can you possibly be to where?
Pretty bad.
Yeah, I mean, I would like that too if I get to just sit there. I have a clip in Halo 3 where I'm on the turret on a social matchmaking pit king of the hill, and I get like two killionaires back to back. I call it Rambo because I'm just mowing everyone down on the turret. That was actually kind of fun, and that's kind of like what Call of Duty is.
Okay, well, we'll take that and we'll go with that. Moving on to the next topic, changes to capture the flag. In case you didn't know, because I'm sure Kyle knows, you can't drop the flag anymore, but instead you're rewarded with the pistol. And by the way, it's no longer, you no longer press X, or whatever your button layout is, to pick up the flag. As soon as you walk over it, it's exactly like Halo 1, so it's the equivalent with the eyeball. As soon as you walk over it, you just grab it. No questions asked. GG. Thoughts? Kicking it off with Kyle.
A lot of people are going to die at this tournament from accidentally picking up the flag. That's for sure. Second of all, the flag running skill, I thought it wasn't, or the flag running attribute, I thought it was like a skill involved. There were some great flag runners and some people that could run that thing like the Army tomorrow. Legit. That kid, okay. Yeah, he was a beast running the flag. He was like running through walls with it somehow. The whole pistol thing, it's going to be interesting to see because I'm not exactly sure how strong the pistol is in comparison and like the range that it's effective at. But as far as the flag goes, I know some of the flag animations look pretty cool. But then again, at the same time, I don't know if this happens for other people, but I'm a button masher. You know, when I press something, I hit it hard, and I would never just backmash someone. I would always animate them. And it gets you killed all the time. That's valuable, very valuable time that everyone's just watching you look like an idiot assassinating someone.
Yep.
I wish you could turn that off.
I don't think you can, which is even worse, because these animations are long. Like, you can, like, come behind the Master Chief and, like, rape him up against the wall and, like, steal his wallet and shit. Like, it's like 3 seconds. It's like 3 seconds of an animation sometimes. And with the flag is even crazier. You, like, fucking joust it through the back of his head and then you, like, stand on him and just finish it. Like, it's absurd. That's, like, 3 seconds. There's a lot of people like you because I'm the exact same way. And that animation always fucked me, but it's going to be in there. So, how I'm looking at these capture the flag changes are capture the flag's done. It's out of the competitive scene to me. There's no reason to even have it in.
Motherfucker, you haven't even played it.
I don't need to. I will see it as it stands. As it stands right now, to me, it's dead.
Done as a community for the last
four
years.
Nope.
We've just everything that comes out.
Yes, exactly.
We're not used to how that's going on.
Oh, you think it's a good idea? You think it's a good idea, Dave?
Let's put it back to just a battle rifle. Oh, you know what? The battle rifle is not the best gun, so let's get the DMR. You start with that. Let's put two snipers on each side and a rocket in the middle, okay? And let's see who wins. Fuck that, man.
All right, Dave, let me bring it down to you from a main slayer perspective and Kyle being a filler, sometimes support, sometimes a slayer. You kind of did it all. Don't really know your niche anymore, but let's put it this way.
Support objective.
Yeah, support objective. Right. Okay, exactly.
Okay, I'll take slayer.
Okay, listen. I have sniper, right?
Mm-hmm.
Towards the end of Halo, like mid-Halo 3 on, people who had the sniper started grabbing the flag. Halo 2, very rare that I would push into the base, even with rockets or with sniper, and even try to get a touch on the flag. It happened, but it was very rare. Now, mm-hmm. I won't be caught dead crossing the fucking 30-yard line going into their base with the sniper trying to grab that flag. There's no point. Why? So my sniper can stay on my back with half a full sniper in it just so when I die they can pick it up? No way. So you know what that means? That's going to mean spawn camping, which isn't even going to happen depending on how the spawns work. You're just going to have a lot of people just jerking off, waiting around for the perfect setup, and it's never going to happen. Think of derelict CTF, right? Like pickup scrim, like pickup fours, derelict CTF, where everyone just sits on the sides and they just rain hell until finally someone gets a lucky nade, and then they cake top, and then it's a 45-minute game just to get the fucking capture the flag game done on one of the smallest Halo 1 maps. That's what it's going to be like, dude. You're not going to have any crazy flag runs anymore. You're going to have just, you're going to wait. And Kyle's going to be constantly going in and dying, and dying. And dying, and dying, until I run out of sniper, and then I'll probably go and grab the flag, maybe, unless it's already spawned up again, in which case I'm going to go grab that.
Well, Scotty, I will say this. Your Halo smarts trump me, okay? I'll give it to you there, but what I'm saying is basic logic. Is you can't knock something until you try it. You got to play it and actually see how it is. Until we play it in a competitive scene, we don't know if it's something we're going to use or not. That's it.
Mm-hmm. I guess, man.
I was just thinking, I didn't watch any Capture the Flag games on from the EGL tournament, but from watching Halo 4 on there, I actually really did enjoy watching it.
I did too. I can genuinely say that as a spectator, I liked some of the matches I saw.
You know,
the sniper seems like
a hard light shield. I actually saw it used effectively, and where I looked at it and said, wow, that's actually not a bad thing to have in this game right now. You know, when they have top control and you got everyone spawning down low, the weapons aren't as powerful as they were in some of the other Halos, so you can't just necessarily break out of a setup like that. But if you're rocking up a ramp, you know, why in the open, and all of a sudden you can bust that hard light shield and stay alive for a few extra seconds, that can really change the outcome of a game.
God, you're like the one person who I knew would like that. You inside would like the hard light shield. That's it. And Walsh, that's it. You're the only people, because you guys are clowns. Once strong siding got invented, I hated everything about you, Side, and Walsh. Everything. The worst people.
I wasn't too bad.
No, you were awful. You were
a 4 cents player, so 5 cents players really got to abuse the strong siding.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, Kyle. This is completely random and pertains nothing to this. I haven't had a controller in a long time. What controllers do people use? I know the MLG controller is like kind of. It's like
Envy
not even
controller.
A question, huh?
NV controllers. I haven't had a good controller in a long time, too. Mm. My last one I had was an NV controller. That was a decent one.
Yo, I like the MLG controller for sports games.
Oh, yeah?
So
that's my shit for sports games. If I play 2K, if I play Madden, the MLG controller is the shit. I can't get used to it on shooters. I think I'm just too used to the other type of controller. Mm-hmm. But yeah, for sure. For sports games, it's dope.
I figured I would ask. I mean, I haven't had a controller since 2011. Played a game of Reach, smashed that son of a bitch straight into pieces on instant gone.
Ooh.
Yeah, you know how it is.
I had two good ones. And
fucking pellet guns.
I let people borrow stuff too much. It always disappears.
So, Scotty, people are saying that in Halo 4, there's going to be no ranking system. That's like something that's like confirmed.
Wait, no ranking system?
I think it's like numerical ranks are out, so you won't have the 1 through 50s.
A different type.
I think they're going to go with that true skill, which is essentially what they've
confirmed, by the way.
Yeah, it's all speculation. So I want to say that it's going to be like true skill based, which is essentially what they said the MLG community playlist was. Which, in Halo Reach, if anyone played that, you know that it was a complete joke. I think ranking systems are something that they really have to look into. And it's not as simple as
they
just...
They can't look into it, Scott.
They can add a playlist where it's actually implemented and it works well. You can't use a true skill. Look at all of these successful games that are out there. You're talking about two games that just stand out, and I'm going to always throw them right back in their face because in hopes to hear it, just to take a look at how it works. League of Legends, StarCraft 2, both great fucking ranking systems. You play it and you're like, wow, Kyle, what did you just hit a Masters in StarCraft 2, right? You nerd? How hard was that?
Uber nerd. It was hard, but that's the only reason I did it, was because it was hard. It's
walk me through
that
it.
Prolongs the life of a game is like that challenge, you know, that to, in order to attain that. I never thought I would get it when I first played it, but I probably thought the same thing in Halo. I remember thinking when Halo 2 came out, I think I was like a level 18, and the highest I'd ever seen was like a 22 right when it came out. And I was like, oh my god, 22, that's so high. You know, and all you do is want to move up in the ranking until you get a 50, and then, you know, there's a 5-star general 50. If there's no ranking system, like, why the hell would people play so much? Like, there's just no point, like, especially, like, in Reach. Like,
Spartan Ops, bro.
Putting all those hours into it, it just was a complete waste. And Halo 3 and Halo 2 was fun, though.
Something that they did from the beginning was extremely successful. Halo 2 rank system was one of the funnest ranking systems.
The best leaderboard on Bungie in the beginning was, I checked that thing every single day.
Yeah, clan matches?
Absolutely.
What's up? Head-to-head?
Head-to-head
was
so sick. Free
clan matches were the shit. Yeah, loved clan matches.
Were the shit.
That clan matches is actually what set the precedent for 2005 DC. Like, that's how it went. And that's crazy.
It's going to happen. I remember that.
And, but, you know, so, I mean, they're straying away from it, but essentially what you're looking that you want to have is a simple algorithm that players get rewarded for winning and you get punished for losing. You should be able to lose a rank. I remember playing Halo 2 and, like, freaking out. I was, like, 14, 15, just with a fucking afro and weird hair and just, like, greasy looking and, like, kind of fat but, like, skinny at the same time. And just, like, screaming in my head that if I lost this, I'd be, like, you know, a 17 instead of an 18. That is what kept me going. And then I'd win, and I'd check and be like, oh, well, it kind of moved up just a little bit. It was here, but now it's here. You know what I'm talking about, the bar. It doesn't even let you know how much is left. You have a bar. And it just kept feeding the fire, and that is what kept Halo 2 going. And if you talk to most of the Call of Duty pros now, like Nadeshot and all these other guys and Optic Merc, they'll tell you that Halo 2 was their favorite ranking system that they've ever played. So it's not hard to recreate it. Now, if you want to take something new like ELO from League of Legends or the whole Master, Grandmaster, Purple, Yellow, Gold, Platinum, whatever the fuck it is in StarCraft, then do it. But you have something that works, and even if you don't want to go with that, go with Halo 3s. It was very simple. It wasn't. You didn't even lose rank, I don't think, right? Could you lose? I don't think you could.
You could then.
You could?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, you definitely could.
You could go from like a 47 to a 46?
Yeah.
Dude, really?
My friend, like,
I only played that game for a year, so I have no idea.
Lots of people's goals were to get 50 that weren't that great. I had a friend that was a Brigadier grade 3 or 4, something ridiculous. He's a 47, and me and a couple other friends, you know, we just like, all right, we're going to get you your 50. We must have spent 2 weeks playing, you know, who knows how many hours we put into it. So many wins, and he never even went up one level. But that right there is 2 weeks of hardcore playing to try and get a 50. If there was no rank system, I would never have spent those 2 weeks doing that. Not even close. I would not have even thought twice about it. Been like, okay, you're not that great at Reach. Who the fuck cares? Because there's no nothing. There's no leaderboard. There's no nothing. It's just a complete waste of time.
So we hope that speculation.
But I mean, just as like a message to 343. There's one thing that every person does, no matter who you are, period, is social comparison. You want to know who you're better than, and you want to know who's better than you. And that's a fact. If you're not going to give us a rank system for whatever reason, and you want to go with true skill, give us some fruity-ass emblem, and give us a leaderboard so we know who's better than us and who's worse.
Game battles is big.
Game battles is big, but the problem is how often is that actually used for Halo players? I mean, yes, we could switch over to that, but, I mean, is it going to do it justice? It could, but it's innate in every Halo player to not compete online because online is bullshit, and online I'd beat the shit out of you.
Again, that's dividing the community, killing the community.
What is? What I just said?
So exciting for Halo 4 is getting all these social motherfuckers in the same room as us and trying to play the same type of game. And that's exactly why, Scotty, I don't want to throw CTF out the window. I want to play exactly what they're playing. I want to play the most popular game types, and let's adapt and do a little bit our way and do a little bit their way. And maybe then, all of a sudden, we see our numbers grow a little bit. I think that could be cool.
Okay. I'll give you that. I will agree that we should give it a shot, but as soon if I see one thing that pisses me off, it's out in my books. I'm not playing it.
Well, let's just get this out there that I don't think Halo 4, no matter how the game is, could be worse for Halo as of right now, because even now, it's still at the pretty low, you know,
yeah.
Given that there's an MLG tournament again, which is huge and just, like, completely ups it, but it's still pretty low of the upper echelon of first-person shooters right now.
Yeah, you know we sold 220-plus team passes for Dallas?
That's huge. That's awesome. That's really awesome, actually.
It's wild. That's like 880 people. Well, it's not like that's exactly what it is if competitors. That's pretty cool. So, I mean, seeing since MLG, I'm actually surprised we sold that much, because for a community who kind of pride themselves with MLG, for MLG just kind of being like, oh, yeah, we'll give you something at Anaheim, show up at Columbus, and then they were like, fuck you. And then they're like, maybe we'll do something to Raleigh, like a small exhibition and nothing. I'm surprised a lot of people didn't just say, I'm not going.
Mm-hmm.
You know? It just shows that it's a loyalty to the game and not the league, which is good. That's exactly what you want. But the problem is now we just have to have more tournaments so that it actually can stay.
And more leagues, you know. I would love to see, like, EGL or European events, like, them decide to come over to America some. And it would create, you know, people going back and forth even more than there is now. So, you know, we've got Australian teams coming over, but you know how awesome it would be to go to Australia to compete in an event? Get to go to CAS. Like, stuff is so sick. And the ability to travel, like, that's probably the best thing that comes out of Halo for a lot of people there, is the ability to travel. You get to visit all these places, not only cities in the United States, but several people have the unique opportunity to go outside of the country and do it, like I've had.
Bastard.
I don't know, man. I don't really see it right away for Halo 4.
Not right away, but
maybe we could see a few more leagues. I hope AGL really comes up hard.
Like, they just got to come out swinging. They got to go like 60 grand in debt with a loan and just fucking swinging for the fences, son, like Signs when he grabs that baseball bat and just beats the shit out of that alien. That's what they need to do. And if they go bankrupt, you know, like at least they tried. You know, that's what we need. Sadly.
Then they just get added to a list of people that owe a lot of other people money.
Exactly, because the recession sucks.
That's the thing, is everyone who's done this has basically gone bankrupt. And, you know, MLG has been fighting that, and they've done a very good job.
Yeah.
And StarCraft came along, and other things came along that kind of helped them along the way. And Halo was definitely a big part of that, right? But everyone has basically failed and gone bankrupt. Maybe some individuals at the top, of course, they're going to make money. But for the most part, and that's why shit has to change. And new leagues have to come in with a new model that has lots of a little overhead and good prize money and a good system for everybody that's fair. And AGL, I think they're a huge step in the right direction, but there needs to be 2-3 more of those. One isn't enough, and if that happens, the community will start growing even bigger, and there we go, MLG can't deny us.
Well, even with, like, let's say you have to consider the economy the way it is. I don't want to go into this topic, but
oh, we can go into this. Ron Paul.
And marketing are what immediately drops when people aren't doing well, and nobody is doing well, so there goes marketing, and there goes entertainment, and that's exactly what Halo is and how it makes its money is marketing, and it's an entertainment sport. So it's like, the fact that MLG is still here is great, and that Halo got picked back up again, like, that's great too. Like, I have a restored confidence in Halo. I was very skeptical even when I went out to E3 and played it. You know, I think I sent an interview or something, you know, I played it for a few hours, and, you know, honestly, I was ready to go do something else. But watching it, when I watched EGL and watched the competitiveness and the tournament play of it, I was like, damn it, why am I commentating? I want to be playing. But
yeah, that's going to happen to you for the first 2 years.
I feel
like
it's going to happen for a long time.
Yeah, it's about 2 years, and then you realize that you're old and washed up, and then you...
Yeah, but if there's other tournaments going around, I could compete in those things.
You could.
Any European teams,
maybe
I'm a free agent.
Maybe if you got my brother's back.
His brother fucking drops him like 4 days out, and we have the same conversations where he's like, oh, it was shady, and we dial back to the beginning of this episode where he's like, oh, well, you know, we were only taping for like 4 days. It's not a big deal.
I mean, there's only a handful. There's only a handful of players. There's only a handful of players in this league that are known or considered to be, you know, loyal and reliable, and Ace is one of them. I don't think anyone can argue with that.
He's my top five players in reach.
Just yeah, Enable left SQ like two or three times, and they took him back each time. And I remember talking to Aaron, it's like, what do you do? They were with Snakebite and Dursky at one point. That team was probably the better decision. That's probably what they should have stuck with. But, you know, I even made the mistake of giving Aaron my input on it, and then sure enough, they went back to the old SQ, you know. But there could have been, you know, the way things turned out now, but, you know, it's hard. It's crazy to think how different things could have turned out even in the past. Like, going all the way back to 2006, Carbon. What if you guys picked up someone else? Could you imagine?
We almost picked up the five, but I was pushing for Ghost.
Right, well, Ghost is probably a good choice, yeah. Or the better choice then, because he just...
He went all out
at the last events. He played awesome.
The last thing, I don't know, maybe two things left. Someone tweeted me asking me about the equipment. I think they're bringing back, like, the tree that regenerates your health and like, the shield depletion bullshit. You know what I'm talking about in Halo 3?
I don't care about this.
It's not the tree. It's, like, that green orb that gives you, like, your shields. No, you don't remember that in Halo 3?
A tree?
Oh, a health regenerator.
Yeah, the health regenerator.
I watched that used.
Yeah, and they asked if... I'm just doing it for this one specific hit. I thought it was a tree. I'm fucking
a tree.
Dude, look at my playthings at Halo 3 and tell me that I actually knew what the fuck what was going on, alright?
I live in the woods, and my trees don't look anything like that little thing.
I live in the country, dog. I'm just saying. It's a canister. It's the same shit.
My God.
But to answer your question, whoever you are, no. They will not be used in competitive play, and I'll take them out myself. There's no way. The fact that they actually implemented them into the game's almost insulting to me. And then the last thing, I guess we're going to talk about, Kyle, didn't you want to talk about, like, opening events, like, beginning of each event,
yeah.
And then, like, as to what we can see for next, because next week we're doing our bracket show, and that's that, and that's what we're doing.
In my opinion of what to expect and what to look for from the first event and what teams do well,
mm-hmm.
As far as the other Halos in the past have gone, it's always, you know, generally first, one of the most prepared and skilled teams. It's always been, you know, like, Final Boss or you guys, who else has been in the finals? Mainly Final Boss. Okay, it was mainly Final Boss. But it's always been a really aggressive team that's somehow been able to overwhelm the other teams, and everyone else doesn't have a good feel for the game enough to be able to hold off those extremely aggressive teams. Halo 4, it's going to be really weird to see, because I think those level of teams that can actually be in the finals at the first event has gone up. So there will be teams that will be able to hold the pushes and early aggression and whatnot. It's going to come down to teamwork. Every Halo has just gone more and more about teamwork. So baiting and switching, you know, waiting for your opponents. The teams that are going to be most successful are the teams that before the guy just runs around the corner into the opponent's base, they maybe hold back a second and wait for a teammate to come up. That's the teams that are going to be the most successful, and that's what teams need to be focusing on and working on going into this event if they want to perform well. You can't just play like an idiot. You can't just APG it around everywhere and expect to win. You know, this is what you're going to have to do. And the level of Halo, especially with the sold-out event, there are going to be way, way, way more than four awesome teams there.
Yeah, you know what's wild is now APG sponsored by NOS. Well, like, that team is. Like, Formal, Heinz, Snipedown, they're sponsored by NOS. So, I mean, imagine a jacked-up APG on NOS just running around the map. That's going to be annoying as shit for a lot of players. But the one thing that I had no idea up until Ace actually made the team switch is that he won the first Halo Reach event with Status Quo. And I completely forgot about that. Ace is one of those players, and Dursky got fourth with Warriors. So right away, their team's kind of in contention for that top four with that team switch.
That can place for top four. Yeah, they really can.
That's scary.
Puckett once told me that Destin is the most natural talented gamer that he's seen.
Dude, Destin, let me tell you a story about Destin. I forget what event it was. Actually, no, that's a different story. Okay, I forget what event it was, but Destin's mom took his Xbox away, like a month and a half, or like a month away from the tournament. And he basically was like, look, guys, if you want to drop me, it's fine. I can't play. Like, my mom's just being a royal bitch, and she doesn't realize that I have the ability to make money from this game because I'm a pro player. I don't understand how people don't get their parents in line by then. Like, it's like, you can't take this away. Take away my cell phone or something. But he showed up to that event, and they got, like, top four, without playing for a month. That kid has natural talent, and he's a tank. He just jumps and fucking bumper jumpers around until you just are like, why would anyone?
But he's smart. That's more of it.
But his movement is so annoying.
Yeah, exactly. That's what it is, his movement. He doesn't just run around the corner and die. Like, APG, you know, you say it's going to be really annoying for teams to go around and APG in it. Okay, APGing it, I'm using that as a term right now, not just talking shit about APG, okay?
That's cool, man. You have it out. I was sitting here in my head. I know DMAQ was sitting here in his head, too, like, man, dude, Kyle's got it out for fucking APG. Yeah, dude. I was wow. I know who's not getting the interview on that team. Jesus Christ.
But if he runs in there, because, I always thought, you know, he still has a lot more potential. He hasn't reached his potential at all. If he just run in there and, you know, he almost always goes one and one. At least one and one. He kills a guy and then maybe puts a little bit of damage on someone else. Well, if you run in there and you get him no shields and the dude busts out a hard light shield, APG is going to die. Now it's a 3v4. People need to start realizing and looking at it. You know, it's like a chess game. You make a move here, you make a move here. Well, when a team goes down, you're up in numbers, and that's when you used to take your advantage. And when you're using that advantage, you're able to get another kill without anyone dying, and all of a sudden it just spirals out of control, and that's how team busts out double caps, or get the first cap and bust out double caps after that, get map control, weapons. Like, it's, you know, it can just spiral out of control is what I'm trying to say.
He's the double kill king. I remember that from Halo 3. I used to do a lot of the logging of the videos, and this motherfucker had so many clips of just nastiness. He had more clips than everybody. He had like half the games as some other people have. He's just so flashy. He's really flashy, really aggressive, and really good at the game. And so, again, Destin, APG, they're kind of like the new wave of kids that have been dominating this game, but don't get too much love sometimes because we have these classic players like T-Squared and Ogre 2 and other players.
Roy, Ola. Yeah, how do you leave them out? But
Roy didn't play well. His last
man, that is true. He didn't. He did not play well. But you know what I'm interested about looking at that team? Is, Kyle, you've teamed with Snipedown, so you have one of the best insights on that. And Formal's my son, so I can clearly make wild accusations that make no sense about him. But what the fuck kind of team makeup is that, and why would they do that?
Like, so we're looking at what?
It's Hines, APG, Snipedown, and Formal. I just, from Formal's gameplay that I casted at Columbus and all throughout 2011, was solely reliant on him hitting big sniper shots. Mm-hmm. And then when he did, they won that event. But when he didn't, they got 3-1 by instinct at Columbus. It's solely reliant on that. And
no,
that's scary.
I don't like having Snipedown and Formal on the same team. I feel like they're really similar. Not saying it's not going to work out.
Yeah.
But there are certain players in the league, Hines being one of them,
that can
join any team and pretty much benefit them because he's such a well-rounded and skilled player. And not only that, but objective work. He's got great objective work, and that's what most teams are lacking to begin with. This could definitely be a powerhouse team. The skill level there, everyone knows the skills that's there. It's going to really come down to, I mean, there's several game changers on that team. Whether or not, you know, it reminds me a lot of like the All-Star games we used to do all the time. Like, that looks like an All-Star team lineup where you would not see that actually at a tournament, but you'd see it in the All-Star matches, you know, all four people that get voted in. I can still see them losing, though.
Yeah, it's kind of like if you put Kobe, Kevin Durant, Russell Westbrook on the same team. It really is, because who's going to get the shots is the question. And,
Kobe's old and he raped someone, so I probably wouldn't go with him.
It really is basically the same thing. Too much star power is going to be their downfall if they're not careful. But if they forget about their egos and forget about who they are and just play the game, I think this team has the most potential out of any lineup. If you just looked at a lineup,
okay.
Hines is a leader now. He's a captain. Formal is a great player, a very young kid. Snipedown, he was almost the most dominant player in a small stint of all time throughout Halo. And so these four...
A bold statement, Cotton.
No, it's true. When he came in and totally dominated Halo 3, I never saw anything like that. And Scotty, the only other thing that could compare is either the Ogre's dominance or your sniper at the end of Halo 2.
Pump the brakes. I don't need my ego getting any more inflated.
No, I'm just saying. You know.
Yeah, just tell me more, man.
It's not the most outrageous thing I've ever heard. I'm not gonna lie.
And that's why a team on paper like this... they got to check their egos at the door. They got to understand that they haven't won tournaments for so long and they've been so good at the game. What are they doing wrong? They have to play a team game. And I think all of them understand that, and that's exactly what we're going to get from them.
What team is Clutch not attending the event? Is Clutch not going? Anyone know?
No, Clutch is definitely going. Is he with Maniac in them?
Well, I'm looking. I have a roster sent to me, if you guys are wondering. I'm not sending a text. I'm not that impolite.
Clutch isn't going? Someone typed?
No, he's not going.
Wow. I did not know that.
D, what are you doing?
I'm moving.
Why?
I gotta get my charger here.
No, this is the cliche Blair Witch Project bullshit. This is what I'm Kyle, you there? You see what I'm talking about? This is what I have to deal with DMAQ every day. He's a child. But yeah, I was looking at the Believe the Hype roster, and it's Cloud, Assault, Lethal, and Maniac, and I was like, where the fuck is Clutch? I can't believe he's not going.
Okay, so I think someone said they dropped Clutch for Lethal.
Wow. Okay, well, D's internet cut out, but that's surprising to me. Clutch is one of those players who excels at a game very early. Mm-hmm. Like that's his niche, and plus, I was really looking forward to seeing Clutch unleash on some people that are brand new into the scene at a tournament setting.
I like having Clutch at the events.
I do too. He's a great trash talker, and he brings that excitement to the table. And we're not going to have that there now.
Sorry.
Yeah, it's okay, D. Don't worry. Everyone's waiting on you to turn on your camera. It's completely cool. And then, you know, dude, I'm going to go on a stretch here and say if 11 and them, like, actually don't go to the event for some reason who have been playing it for a month, I have my eyes set straight on Triggers Down. No questions asked. And the only reason is because Nated has played that game almost probably as much as some of the players who are playing it currently right now. He's played that game a lot.
All of them, really.
Yeah. Well, has Neighbor really been playing it? Neighbor hasn't gotten the chance to, has he?
I don't know if I can comment on all that stuff, but I'm sure that they have. They're up in Washington, right by all that stuff, you know. I'm sure they have.
Interesting. Well, I mean, Triggers Down has definitely got to be one of those teams. Nated at the beginning of games is terrifying in every way, shape, and form. And in a game like Halo 4, where it seems like... The one thing I can say that it seems to be the general consensus is that 343 hit the nail on the head with the beginning weapons. They're all extremely dominant, and of course one's going to be the best. We just have to have the time to figure that out. But when Nated has...
DMR is the best weapon.
I've heard the light rifle's the best. I've heard the DMR is the best. I've heard the BR is the best. I don't know. Kyle, do you know anything about that? Okay.
Like, I would, but they might have changed it. I heard they've done a lot of changes since last time I played it, so...
DMR.
Is it? D, I don't trust you. I don't think you've watched a single video.
Come on. Check the chat.
Is it the DMR? I don't have the Twitch up, man. It makes my shit lag.
There you go. Yeah.
It is a DMR? Okay, so everyone will be playing the DMR. But, I mean, still, regardless, Nated is going to be terrifying. And you want to talk about the beginning of a game... With rushing and just unpredictability, Nated's the king of that. He lives in unpredictability. No one has figured out how Nadeau's played. You remember in 2007 when he all of a sudden decided to play 7 sensitivity and destroyed everyone at that tournament, Kyle?
How about last season when he decided to play objective all season?
Yeah.
Totally switched up this game.
Yeah, Kyle, thanks for that. It was great talking.
Yeah.
Jackass. What's his deal? His internet cut out. Where are you? What I'm trying to say here is my favorite going into the bracket show next week is going to be Triggered Down. And I want to know whose yours is. You're going to have to kick that camera up. I got a straight shot of your tits and no face. You know what I'm saying? And you're not
Oxford
a chick.
University represented.
You don't even know where that is.
That's where I went. Next week on the bracket show, there's going to be a few teams that obviously you don't want to go away from. Because, you know, you could talk about SQ, but they've played together forever. And so natural chemistry is going to come into play. But then, again, they also have the young guns at the same time. You know, you talk about natural chemistry, why don't you talk about instinct? Well, I don't consider them the young guns anymore.
That's so weird that Pistola's like, is he 21 now? He's like 20 or something.
I don't know. He is like...
He can get into rated R movies.
He's 19.
Yeah, he can get into rated R movies. That's wild to me. Do you remember Little Lola?
Yeah.
13. Running around, the guy from the little...
Like Minkus.
Yeah.
And most of these, you know, if you don't understand the reference to Minkus, that sucks for me. Because that means I'm old as shit. That's fucked up.
Dude, it's a different generation. But dude... So for anyone, since Kyle's gone and I'm just trying to buy time for him to get his internet in check, when Pistola first stepped onto the scene, everyone knew him for his FFA presence. And that really didn't go, oh, shit, the graphic. Dude, move to your right. Move to your right. No. Move to your... You're in both graphics. It's funny. So when Pistola first started out, and you're creeping me out, he was known for his FFA presence, and this guy named Killen, who was Karma's best friend, tried to grab a hold of him and never let him go, and he tried to turn him into this 4v4 player, and it just wasn't happening. And he just couldn't grasp that concept, so instead what happened was is Halo 3 came out and they got rid of FFA, so Pistola was submerged into this culture where 4v4 was it. And he's like 14, 15 years old, he just didn't have that mental capability to really excel as a player. And because of that, he never really got a solid shot at Halo 2, but Halo 3 came out and he was a dominant, and since then he's just been destroying. So... It's still so... Okay, dude, you've got to fucking stop. God.
Stop. Dude, that was so much fun. Oh, man, that was awesome.
Oh, this is wonderful. Dee, I'm going to go ahead and make... I apologize in advance. This is going to look like shit for a second, but Dee, I'm going to resize you, and I'm just going to go ahead and take you out for the time being. So what's going on right now is Kyle is actually getting hit offline by, what's his name? PJ, right? PJ?
Fuck! Damn it, PJ!
Right?
Asshole!
You know, dude, I can't believe it's actually still going on. Like, that is what's mind-blowing to me. And I don't understand if, there's nothing, like, anyone can do about this, D? To your knowledge, there's nothing anyone can do?
I think legally he's gonna be fucked.
He's gotta be. Something's gotta give.
I think illegally I'm gonna fuck him up.
Yeah, you ain't got the balls. Come on, let's be real.
If I see PJ,
you can't have an open threat, dog. You know what I'm saying? Like that's alibi.
If I see him.
No, if you see him, you're gonna give him like a hug. You can't have motive, dude. You know how many TV shows I watch that motive indicates who killed the person? You know what I'm saying?
I'm gonna give him a hug.
Yeah,
that's
there you go.
Do.
That's what I'm talking about. You gotta keep that alibi straight. You know what I'm saying? I'm looking out for you. In case once again, no one actually knows what DDoSing is. I don't really know all the technical terms to it, but basically they just flood your IP with a bunch of packets, and you get knocked offline and you can't get back on. Players like Formal have been enduring through this, and a lot of other people who have been streaming, with the exception of Ninja, who I think got it, he was eventually getting knocked offline for quite some time as well. No, that did. Yeah, I mean, what is this, an M. Night Shyamalan fucking twist?
No, this is the Rachel twist.
The Rachel? I don't get it. I don't get that reference.
Oh, what's her name? The one, Raquel. Raquel twist.
Yeah, easy, easy. Sorry. But so, everyone's been enduring through this, and players aren't able to even make money from streaming anymore, and it's really hurting the community, like, a lot. And it's all because this kid, PJ, wants to be on people's friends list, so he blackmails them. He's like, hey, listen, put me on your friends list, let me knock you offline. But here comes the fucking fine print. As soon as you put me on, I want to play games with you, and if you're playing with your team and I want to play games with you, I'm going to knock you offline still. So there's nothing you can do about it besides just take it, and that's disgusting to me. What in the world happened that people can just fucking do this kind of shit? You know what I'm saying, D?
Here's my thing.
No, there's not a thing. It's why... Who gets satisfaction off of literally all day just...
I got a thing.
Okay.
If you do this type of shit... This shit to me sounds mad strenuous. Almost kind of genius. Doing all this work and really just kind of controlling... your social lifestyle by controlling all these motherfuckers' paychecks. If you do this, then why can you not do something productive in society? Don't you realize shit is fucked up out there and you could help? PJ might be the next Zuckerberg. I don't know. But, motherfucker, stop spending your time ruining our lives. And start doing the right thing.
But the right thing to him is the wrong thing, man. It's all perception driven. You know how that shit works.
No, I don't believe he's the next Zuckerberg, okay? But all I'm saying is, really, man, it's kids, man. I don't understand why they do dumb shit like this. It really doesn't accomplish anything. Nope. They're ruining other people's paychecks. Honestly, I would love to see legal action taken against PJ, and I'll testify against him, for sure.
Oh, absolutely.
I'll do that for sure, because it's not cool. You know, everybody's trying to grow this community, everybody's trying to get together, and then all of a sudden, this motherfucker got to fuck it up. So, you know, if PJ, you watching, I know you're watching, that's not cool, man. And you know, damn, I'm talking to you right now, you know, you want to call me, talk to me about it, I'm not going to be on your friends list. I'll talk to you about this, though. You know, that shit is just not cool, dude. And you continue to do that, you're going to put a damper on the community that you fucking stalk on.
He already did. He already did put a damper on the community,
you
man.
You stalked this community, but you fuck it up at the same time.
I think he actually attempted... I think he actually...
You don't find attractive. What are you doing?
I think he actually hit off AGL at one point, too. At their first event. I'm not 100% certain on that. I could be delusional. I tried to buy Kyle time, but he's completely fucked for the whole night. He just texted me saying there's no chance. So, PJ, I salute you by saying fuck you. yeah, you're a really cool guy, though, man. Keep it up. Seriously. So, D, closing thoughts, man.
I want to talk one more time about COD, this whole Halo thing.
Okay.
You know, I hate that question was asked, you know. Sonny asked it because he asked it, and, I'm not blaming Sonny for asking it. That's the thing. You know, he did what he did. But I just hate that the question was asked, the communities were divided. I don't think that should be the goal here. I think we should all be united. You know, online qualifiers, invite the best 80 teams out for each community. Let's have one big tournament. All the best from each community get to represent. I think that's my plan. I feel like a president debating right now, stating my plan, but that's my plan. I think that would work best for everybody, and that would keep everybody happy. If you do this and start pinning everybody against each other, you know, you start lowering stream numbers, lowering the quality of console shooters and just lowering the quality of esports. You know, whether you like that word or not, Scotty.
I despise it. You know how it is.
You know, that's what they're doing with that move, in my opinion, with just a simple thing like a tweet. And I think if they went the other way about it, we'd see better results in the long run, although short term, maybe not for them.
Well done. I'm impressed. I just wanted to say some closing statements. Kyle, sorry, bro. You're the weakest link, man. How outplayed is that, right? How outplayed is that? When's the last time you heard that? Can't even tell you. I couldn't tell you. Probably Family Guy. But besides that, APK, a Polish-Korean, follow him on Twitter. Because of him, we're able to have Skype video. He's a proud member of the Halo Council. He works his ass off. I technically don't even know what he does because, well, I'm busy. But definitely follow him. Without him, this show couldn't happen. So another round of applause for everyone in the Halo Council. And if you guys have feedback or... Actually, no, not the feedback, because most of you guys are just assholes. Probably make fun of both of me and DMAQ. But if you guys want anything talked about, just fucking tweet us. We'll gladly do it. Because next week, we have the bracket show. And right now, on my phone, I have... One second. I have 2, 4, 6. I have 8 teams that I'm going to be talking about. 8 out of 220. So if you want your team to be talked about and you have prior experience and we know who you are, throw your name out there. Send both of us a tweet and Elamite and just say, hey, this is our roster. This is what we're coming with. Because we want to make the bracket show actually good. If we have 8 teams, you guys are going to be getting a 25-minute show where both of us are like, oh, well, NSYNC looks good, but status quo is right there. Yeah. You know, that's just a circle jerk. No one wants that. That's gay. I want to tell DMAC he's retarded.
It's okay if it's gay.
Okay. Yeah, it is. It is. You know, I'm not, you know. Nah, they see a beard and they're like, oh, this guy's a fucking Republican. He's so against gay marriage. Fucking abortions, too. This guy's a fucking scumbag. Libertarian.
I was going to say something.
All right, I'm closing out of the show.
I was going to say it.
Right closing out of the show. Go
right
for it.
Right before you close. All right, I'll close it off. But, guys, I know it sucks that we got to do this, but fuck it. If we got to do it, let's do it. Everybody tweet Sundance. Hashtag Halo. Tweet it twice if you got to tweet it twice. Whatever you got to do. But, hey, we ride or die for our game. That's why you guys are watching this. That's why we started Season 2 up again, because we want to make sure that Halo 4 is starting on the right foot. And so that's what it is, man. Be back next week. Talk about the bracket show. Hit us up on Twitter over the week. And hit Sundance up. Halo. Hashtag Halo. Hashtag Halo. Over and over and over again. All right? We'll see you next week. We love you, motherfuckers, even though we hate you, motherfuckers. Peace.